this guy's in the way.
Okay. Mr. President, can Noriega stay in Panama if he leaves power?
I hope not.
Mr. President, the Democrats said they're going to make a campaign issue of your veto of the trade bill.
Well, that ought to help our side.
How?
Y'all tell the truth.
But why not give people who have run out of work some advance notice? What's wrong with that, sir?
Well, as an old labor union president, I suggest that's a matter that belongs in the management labor contracts between the union and the people.
Not the law?
We brought you a special young man that wanted to present you with a gift. Go ahead, Mike.
I want to give you this Brewer's jacket. Okay.
Well, Mike, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Say,
aren't you glad he's not from Baltimore?
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And I know all that you've been doing, and you've been pretty busy for the last couple of years.
Yes, I have.
Very good cause.
Okay, wait right here within the family. Yes, okay.
Sam,
my wife, Mr. President,
yes,
Sam.
Yes, hello there. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
And the family.
Sarah,
this is Sarah. This is Mike's sister.
Yeah, good to see you.
This is Mikey's mom, Carol.
Hello there. Mr. President.
Mikey's dad, Ray.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Let me take Mikey out this way.
We'll get a family picture here.
All right, let me leave Mike there then.
Yes.
Just tell me, Rebecca, I'll do whatever you say. Anybody need film? I'm covered. ASA 1000, 200.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, thank all of you for what you do, but Jerry and I, I don't think anybody can add up all that you've done.
It's so kind of you to see us again.
Well,
it goes a long way for him and for us and for the association. Come here, my darling.
I have a group picture.
Right. Yeah, nice group picture. I hope
you're ready. Right here.
Can we see it?
Not Polaroid, sorry.
Well, let me. Oh, all right. And I do thank you for that. I can even. Here's something for you.
Oh.
Don't drop it. It happens to be glass. It's a jar with the presidential seal on it. But it's what's inside that's important. It's still the jelly beans.
Oh. He'll never get to the hotel with it, you know that.
Thank you very much.
Well, you're more than welcome. And to all of you. It's a great cause, and you're all serving it nobly.
Did you give Nancy our love?
I sure will.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well.
Congressman, Pete Wright didn't get a chance to say hello when he came.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, used to do it.
Yeah, they're the home state.
Yeah.
Yep.
This guy's the important one. Well, these two will have a whole. I'll lose votes if I do.
Come, I think you've got a few to take yet, and we'll get out of your way.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you again, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir. Good luck to you. Don't hold that, don't break that, Mike, because you're never gonna see it.
Mr. President, you remember Bill Marriott?
I sure do. Bill, how are you?
Nice to see you. Thanks for having us here today.
Bill, Frederick.
Really nice to see you.
Nice to have you.
It's not a rich cash, I think, Vice President.
All right.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Bill Tiefel.
Mr. President.
Pleasure to meet you.
Sir, right here. That's great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Al Rankin, Vice President.
Nice to meet you, sir.
You know Fred Malik?
Yeah. Hey, Mr. President, how are you?
Well, just fine.
Good to see you.
He's going to work for George Bush.
I know what I was going to say. I'm very grateful that you've given the time and that you will do that and run that convention.
Now, how about that? Yes. That's good, isn't it? Mohammed Ishan, our director of catering.
Hi. Honored to be here, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
General manager of our hotel, John Dixon.
Hello. It's good to see you again.
John. Good to see you.
Walter Ernst, director of food and beverage at our hotel.
Pleasure to meet you again.
Kurt Krauss, Director of Marketing.
Pleasure, sir.
How are you?
Thanks.
I line up there for the group here.
Right.
And this is my special occasion also for me to say thank you to you.
Well, these are the $1,000 work. All I did is just show up a couple times.
Well, but also it was quite a sacrifice to make it and give a home to the press here. Summit meeting.
Anything we can do to keep the press happy, we're
we're most grateful because we were coming up empty.
Well, we're delighted to have the opportunity.
Okay, great. Everybody's looking right here. Thank you, Mr. President.
All right, and now just a little souvenir of having been here. These are keychains. Hotel people must have keys. Key rings, I should say.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And they all have the seal.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
What a great pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for seeing us. And we're proud of you and what you've done for the country.
Well done. Thank you very much.
We really are. We've given you one of our very best men right here. Keep the tradition going.
Well, we're most appreciative of that. And again, it's always a pleasure to. Of course, it's a pleasure for you because usually when I arrive, I make a speech.
That's great. We're glad to have you come. Thrilled to have you come. Thank you for this very much.
Great pleasure.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Mr. President, Jim McCurry, my new playmate.
Mr.
President.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you again.
I saw you being sworn in.
Yes. Well, I appreciate your taking time to watch that. It was quite an occasion in my life. Got chill bumps.
Hey, listen. It's quite an occasion in a lot of people's lives when you stop to think that 4th District is 80% Democrat.
That's right.
And you're the first Republican in 114 years from there.
Well, that's right. We hope to keep it that way for a while.
You too.
And with your help, we will, and appreciate the help that you gave during the campaign. It was very important.
Well, glad to do anything we could, and really appreciate your work.
You're going to keep your word on the trade bill? I guess you want me to vote to sustain your veto?
Yes.
I will, I've got, as you well know, in the 4th District of Louisiana, there's a considerable oil and gas constituency. And I'm talking with them. I'm going to continue to talk with them this week and next week. But I will...
Tell them what you're going to do.
I'll end up on the right side.
Good.
I'll do what's best for the country.
Thanks, Mr. President.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Incidentally, even after meeting doing that bill, I let the word go up there. You can tell your constituency that the elimination of the windfall profits tax I want in the next bill.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to tell them. That when I finally tell them I'm going to vote to sustain the veto, I'm going to tell them that we have assurances on the Senate side.
Particularly, Jimmy, you just heard it back from the President.
Yep. That's all right. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Dr. Jack,
Mr. President, it's delighted to meet you.
Well, nice to see you.
Thank you. Right. Ms. Judy Lugoski, how are you? This is a pleasure. Mrs. Judy Gibson,
hello,
Mr. President.
There.
Ms. Jordy Heath.
Hello.
Hello. Mr. Charlie Craven.
Present.
Hello there.
Republican National Committee. Ms. Jean Moore.
Hello there. Well.
Ma'am, President. Thank you.
Ms. Patricia Shepherds.
Hello there.
Cindy
Breyer.
Good to see you. We're looking forward to seeing you.
Ma'am. Thank you. Okay.
Ms. Karen Wilcox. Dr. Carmen Lee.
Thank you very much.